Hey, hello everyone, my name is Dinesh Krishnan. In this video tutorial, we're going to understand how to perform the parts of speech using Wordino Core NLP. Right? So to do that, we already created Wordino the pipeline instance, right? So here we're going to enable Wordino one of the property called POS, that is called Wordino parts of speech. Once that is enabled, I'm going to create Wordino the new class. I'm going to create the class called Wordino POS example, right? The parts of speech example. So obviously I'm going to introduce what in the public static void main. Here we need to get a pipeline, right, to perform what the parts of speech, right? So to get the pipeline, Sanford Core NLP. So this instance can be get it by using what get pipeline method, right? So once that is done, obviously I'm gonna introduce what few string. I'm gonna say that hey, hi, I'm Dinesh Krishnan. Right, so very simple statement. So now we have to feed this particular string into what the core document. So to do that, core document equal to new core document, pass the text that you have, right? So once the core document is actually created, we have to annotate this core document with what the pipeline. So how to do that? Sanford Core NLP dot annotate, you have to pass what the core document, right? In the core document, so what we're going to perform, we're going to perform the parts of speech, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to call a method called document, core document dot, there is a method called tokens, which is going to give you the tokenized string, right? So that is going to return you the list of core label. So here, core label list, right? So let me import it from java.util package. So that is actually what imported. Now what exactly I'm going to do? I'm going to perform So the iteration over what? The core library list. So for core label list. So it's a core label, right? So every time I'll get a core label from the list. So what I'm going to do, actually I'm going to perform the parts of speech, right? So to do that, what I have to do, core label dot get, there is a method called get. Here you have to pass the exact annotation, right? Annotation class. So what is annotation class? Core annotations dot, so there is annotation class called parts of speech annotation, right? If you pass this, that is actually going to give you what? The parts of speech string that you can actually hold it in the POS string if you want. What I'm going to do, I'm going to print this POS along with the label string. So to do that, core label dot original text plus equal to plus, I'm going to say POS that we found, right? Let me quickly run this program. We'll see what is going to happen. Here we go. Now you can see the parts of speech is generated for the given string, right? So what exactly this UH, PRP, then VBZ, VBP, then NNP, what is this? This is nothing but the parts of speech concept. So if you want to know, if you want to understand what exactly that symbol represent, I can actually show you. Let me create the new file. In the resource, I'm going to create a file called info of POS. Let me paste the content that I have. You can see that this is the exact representation of the parts of speech. So okay, fine. Now what we have, let's consider Dinesh. The Dinesh actually what? NNP, right? So what is the NNP exactly? NNP, if you look at it in the given list, you can see it's a proper noun. Obviously, it's a proper noun. Dinesh, again, it's a proper noun, right? When you take I, what is I? I is actually PRP. What do you mean by PRP? It's a personal pronoun. This is nothing but parts of speech. This can be used in many use cases in a real-time application.